الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، الذي يجعل بعد العسر يسرا. أحمده سبحانه وتعالى حمدا يزيدنا به نعما وخيرا، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، يخلق ما يشاء ويختار، المتفرد في الكون نهيا وأمرا، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وعنم على عبدك ورسولك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who make ease after hardship. Now thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he deserved. I testify there is nothing worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And he creates or he chooses what he wants. And he creates what he wishes. I testify that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our role model, is the messenger of Allah and his prophet. أما بعد فاتقوا الله عباد الله. Fear Allah, you the slaves of Allah. وذكروا أن للمتقين في الدنيا حياة طيبة ولهم في الآخرة جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار. Fear Allah, and remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have promised for the believers a goodly life on this earth. وَلَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ, and Allah has promised them in the hereafter, jannatin, gardens or paradise, تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ, flowing underneath this paradise are rivers. أَيُّهَا الْمُسْلِمُونَ, all you the Muslims, تَيْسِيرُ الْعَسِيرِ وَتَسْهِيلُ الْأُمُورِ عَمَلٌ تَحْفُ إِلَيْهِ النُّفُوسِ, making hardship ease, it is something that our life always like. عباد الله, the slaves of Allah, وَلَقَدْ بَشَّرَنَا اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ بِأَنَّ الْعُسْرَ يَعْقُبُهُ يُسْرٌ. Allah give us a glad tidings that indeed with any hardship there is an ease. In other words, بِأَنَّ الْعُسْرَ يَعْقُبُهُ يُسْرٌ, the hardship is overcome with ease. فَقَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Sharh, فَإِنَّمَا الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا, إِنَّمَا الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا, which means indeed the ease with hardship, the ease with hardship. قَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى سَيَجْعَلُ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ عُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Surah Al-Talaq, verse 7. Allah says, Allah will grant after hardship ease. وَالتَّقْوَى, fearing Allah, يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ, the slaves of Allah, مِفْتَهُ ذَلِكَ كُلِّ, it is the key of all this ease. When you have hardship, or when hardship comes to your way, the only thing that can make that hardship becomes an ease is when you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا. And whoever fears Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a matter of his destiny. In other words, he will make his life or hardship easier for him. The Surah Al-Talaq, verse 4. Allah said in Surah Al-Layl, most of us know this, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. Allah says, whoever gives an honor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people say, مَنْ أَعْتَى أَيْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, whoever gives for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for showing off, وَاتَّقَى, and he have fear in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى, and he believe and testify the kalimatu la ilaha illallah with its conditions, فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى, Allah will make things easier for him. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make things easy for us. وَمِنَ الْإِحْسَانِ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ, among kindness, تَيْسِيرُ, التَّيْسِيرُ عَلَى كُلِّ مُعْسِرُ, is to facilitate, is to make it easy for anyone that had hardship. إِمَّا بِإِنْذَارِهِ إِلَى مَيْسَرَةٍ, example, to give him time until ease comes to him. كَمَا جَاءَ فِي الْحَدِيثِ, وَمَنْ يَسَّرَ عَلَى مُعْسِرٍ يَسَّرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, أَخْرَجَهُ مُسْلِمٍ فِي صَحِيحِهِ, which means, anyone that make it easy on the person that having hardship, yassara Allahu alayhi fi dunya wal akhirah, Allah will make things easier for that person this world and the year after. For example, you have loaned somebody something and he's finding it very difficult to repay back. You should give him time. Give him time to pay you back. Don't just say, you know what? I'm going to take you to the prison. I'm going to take you to the court. Now you end up doing good, and now you have destroyed all this good by taking him to prison or to the court. You're not going to make any good relation anymore after that. So when you started something good, make sure you end it in a good way. عباد الله إليكم بعض أدعية تيسير الأمور من الكتاب والسنة. Here are some of the supplications that will make hardship ease from the Kitab and the Sunnah. And some of these supplications, it has been made by the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his prophets. One of these, كدعي نبينا موسى عليه السلام. Like the supplication of Sayyidina Musa, where he says, قال رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Surah Taha 25-27. The justification here where he says ويسر لي امري, make things easy for me. He was having hardship. Like the solution of the nude of his tongue. People cannot understand him. So he has to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take that nude from him so that the people will understand. It was a hardship for him. Speaking to people, they cannot understand you. He supplicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to his supplication. وَمِنْ ذَلِكَ دُعَاءُ سَيِّدِنَا يُونُسَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. The supplication of Jonah, Prophet Yunus. حَيْسُ نَاجَ رَبَّهُ. Wherein he supplicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he called upon Allah, and he said, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. Allah responded, فاستجبنا له ونجيناه من الغم وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين. سورة الأنبياء verse 87-88, which means لا إله إلا أنت, there is no God but you, glory I oppressor. He make himself as somebody that oppressing people. Why he needs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's response? Meaning he feel guilty. He plead guilty in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for running away from his own people. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after he has already pleaded guilty, Allah say, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. Allah say, we answered him and saved him from grief, min al gham, from grief. وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and also shall save the believers. The way we save him from the belly of the world, this is the way we will save the believers if they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we help them in their hardship. And the last and final one, among the supplications of the prophets, dua of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the supplication of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alladhi kana yad'u bihi inda ta'assur al-umur. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to supplicate this supplication when things become hard to him. So if things become hard on you today, you don't have to be surprised. Even the messengers of Allah, they used to have hardship. So what about you, the ordinary human being? Do you think you're just gonna live like that? Everything is easy, easy go for you. And the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala themselves, they have hardship. They have been tested in various ways, different ways. Me and you, we should know that hardship must come to our way. Nobody is here that can say he never have hardship in his life. Sunanillah ala al-khalq. It is the sunnah of Allah upon me and you. But we have to overcome it. It happens. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to supplicate with this dua. He said, Allahumma la sahla illa ma ja'altahu sahla wa anta tajalul hazana idha shi'ta sahla. He said, oh Allah, there is nothing easy except what you made ease. And you are the one that make grief if you want to become ease. Multaziman fi dhalika adab ad-du'a wa sunani. And you must follow in these supplications, its conditions, and its manners. Meaning, supplication to Allah, it has conditions and manners. How to supplicate to Allah. Wa min amin hadhi al-adab. Some of these, al-ikhlasu lillah. You should be sincere in supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you have to start your supplication with bihamdillahi wa thana'i alayhi. To praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to send salutation to the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you have to plead guilty in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I did this to you wrong, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I want you to pardon me and to make things easy for me. And another one, wa itabati al-mat'ami fi dhalika ay bi akli al-halal al-tayyib. And you must purify what you eat. You must eat halal. You don't eat haram before you stand in front of Allah and start supplicating to Him. You must eat halal. And this is our problem today. Nobody cares how he earns his wealth. This is our problem. You supplicate to Allah. What is in your stomach is not halal. Do you expect Allah to respond to you? In those days, our grandfathers, when they supplicate to Allah, they will see the response. Why? Because they only eat halal. But me and you today, we are here. We don't care how we earn what we earn. We just want to earn, and just eat, or consume. We don't care. And this is the problem, brothers and sisters. Awrafuliyadain, and you have to raise your hand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. And among the manners, واجتناب الحرام الخبيث. You must keep away from filthy things. Doing filthy things that makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upset upon you. وإظهار الحاجة والإفتقار إلى الله تعالى. And you have to tell Allah or let Allah know what is your problem, what are you looking for. Yes, Allah knows everything. But you say, Allah, I want this, give me this. Make this easy for me. And you do not make dua by swearing at people. Allah destroy this. Allah destroy this. Allah do this to this. This is not a manners of Muslims. This is not our manners. Look the one that below you. Don't look the one that on top of you. But some other traditions, they always push me and you. Look at your friend. He is very rich. Why can't you be rich like him? Do what he is doing, so you become rich. The hadith is opposite. Look the people that below you, the people that doesn't have anything to eat. Don't look the people on top of you, otherwise you commit haram. And if you do this, it is likely that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to your supplication. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَهُ هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِّمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Say, thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mercy. So let Him rejoice. It's better than what they are gathering. After you supplicate to Allah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond to your call. Then you become rejoice after that. We're going to see what the scholar says in the tafsir of the first verse that we just recited, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. جَاءَ فِي بَسْطِ مَدْلُولِ أي في تفسير قوله تعالى فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. إن مع العسر يسرا قول بعض أهل العلم. Some of the tafsir, in other words, the interpretation of this verse, some of the scholars says هذه بشارة عظيمة. It is a great glad tiding. أنه كلما وجد عسر وصعوبة فَإِنَّ الْيُسْرَ يُقَارِنُهُ وَيُصَاحِبُهُ حَتَّى لَوْ دَخَلَ الْعُسْرُ حُجْرَ ضَبٍّ لَدَخَلَ عَلَيْهِ الْيُسْرُ فَأَخْرَجَهُ. انتهى كلامه. They said, this is a great glad tiding. أنه كلما وجد عسر, whenever you found a hardship, فَإِنَّ الْعُسْرَ يُقَارِنُ وَيُصَاحِبُ. You must have an ease. Whenever hardship comes, wait for the ease. They said, حَتَّى وَلَوْ دَخَلَ الْعُسْرُ. Even the hardship entered the hole of a lizard, لَدَخَلَ عَلَيْهِ الْيُسْرُ. And the ease will go to that hole of that lizard and take out of the hardship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, سَيَجْعَلُ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ عُسْرٍ يُسْرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make after the hardship ease. وَإِنَّهَا لَبِشَارَةٌ عَظِيمَةٌ. This is a great glad tidings, يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ, the slaves of Allah. لمن أصابه العسر ونزل به الضر وأحاط به البلاء واشتد عليه الكرب. For anyone that have hardship, فليبشر بالاقتراب النصر والفرج. Let him get ready, or let him wait for the ease. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised that after any hardship, there is an ease. فاتقوا الله يا عباد الله في الله سبحانه وتعالى واحسنوا الظن بالله and have good thinking in Allah سبحانه وتعالى وثقوا بوعد الحق الصادق and believe and trust what Allah has promised. الذي لا يتخلف, it will never miss, it will always happen. The promises that Allah has promised me and you, it will happen. No one can tell me, since he started having hardship, the hardship just continue up to now. And he cannot tell me, every day, he have hardship. Whenever you have hardship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy. وَلَا يَتَبَدَّلْ. And what Allah has promised us, it will never change. أَنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. With ease, after any hardship, there is an ease. واذكروا على الدوام أن الله سبحانه وتعالى قد أمركم بأمر بدع بنفسه. Allah has commanded you with something that he started with himself. What is that? It's to send the salutation to the noble prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما من صلى علي واحدة صلى الله بها عليها أسرا. اللهم صل وبارك وانعم على حبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وارض عن الأربعة الخلفاء أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وأنا معهم بعفوك وكرمك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الإسلام أعداء الدين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يسر أمورنا اللهم يسر أمورنا اللهم يسر أمورنا اللهم فرج همنا اللهم فرج همنا اللهم فرج همنا اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين والمسلمات اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم واعف عنهم واعف فيهم ووسع مدخلهم واغسلهم بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقهم من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الابيض من الدنس يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم الف بين قلوبنا اللهم الف بين قلوبنا اللهم الف بين قلوبنا اللهم وحد صفوفنا يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير. اللهم بارك لنا في أبنائنا اللهم بارك لنا في أبنائنا اللهم بارك لنا في أبنائنا اللهم اهدهم إلى الصراط المستقيم اللهم اهدهم إلى صراطك المستقيم يا أرحم الراحمين. وأقيموا الصلاة.